Hello, everyone. It's Adam from Corpulent Geek, joined with
Christina, Sci-Fi Christina.
Hey, look at that. She changed it up this time.
Yeah.
And we're here to bring you part two of this week's Trailer Thursday. I wanted to make it Trailer Tuesday, but Tuesdays during the Star Trek Discovery season are Star Trek Discovery.
Yes.
So it would roll off the tongue better if it was that, but it's not. So
we call it Thriller Thursday.
But they're not all going to be thrillers. Some are going to be.
I didn't say thriller. I said trailer.
We'll believe that part never happened. As you can see, we're because Ant-Man and the Wasp is coming up soon.
Ant-Man and the Wasp, yeah.
And we were, the word isn't burned out, but it was oversaturated with, oversaturated isn't even the thing. I was emotionally spent after Infinity
Wars.
Yes, yes. Really, I mean, we came back, we were able to do the thing, and then it was like I just gotta think and not disappear in dust. Now we are gonna bring you the second trailer, I believe it is, for Ant-Man and the Wasp.
Yeah.
So, how long have you been Ant-Man again?
Not long. It just sort of happened.
Oh.
I wish I could fight bad guys like you.
You gotta be bold if you're leaning out there with a little gun.
Maybe you just need someone watching your back.
Hi. Look, someone competent watching your back.
Yeah.
Like a partner.
Dr. Pym, I actually heard what happened to you.
Hello, that guy.
That's when his crazy creepy ghost who like walks through walls and stuff. Stole your tech.
Oh no.
Now supposed to take over the world or whatever. Who would have believed that in your hour of need you would turn to us?
Not me.
Mm. Because we robbed you. Do you remember?
Yeah.
That's us.
He does this awkward back. So well.
Mm-hmm.
It's both of you.
Ant-Man and the Wasp teaming up.
Follow my lead.
Yeah. She seems more intense.
Oh, what was that? No.
Oh gosh.
Aww.
You go low, I'll go high.
I have wings. Why would I go low?
Good point.
Yep. Oh.
Yeah, that growing
that
building.
Building just appeared. Oof.
We're gonna die.
Pretty cool.
We didn't die.
Not yet.
Hey, what'd I miss?
We were just tiny.
He's like, yeah.
Yeah.
I was partners with Hank on a project called Goliath.
How big did you get?
My record, 21 feet. You?
65 feet.
65.
If you two are finished comparing sizes.
65.
I like it. They're both wearing the standard Marvel issue. We're undercover, so we're wearing dark
ball caps. And yeah.
Oh,
I love whenever he gets big and he's like, oh.
This is pretty cool.
That's awesome. I think that's what I love the most about Ant-Man is just his awe and wonder of what is going on at every moment, which is why she's so intense because she. That was what you wanted to be doing.
Mm-hmm.
Kicking ass.
And taking names?
Maybe.
No.
Taking ass.
All right, that's from Infinity War. Now you're done spoilers. Now I got to throw a spoiler warning up.
It was just one phrase, and they wouldn't even know where it was from if you hadn't said anything.
Maybe they would have. Maybe that's how they finally defeat Thanos.
By
taking ass.
Oh, I don't even know what that would look like.
We're just terrible people.
Yeah.
So in the first trailer there, they showed the building getting shrunken down and him pulling out the handle and taking it away. And I don't understand how that would work.
There would be in the big building, like when it was built,
a
these
giant
like
F-handle.
Giant. Yeah. That would be awesome. Oh, and then people getting on the roof and being like, what is this for?
Yeah. What is it? This is a weird.
I don't know.
It's kind of artsy looking, maybe.
I love it.
They're not showing us any footage of Michelle Pfeiffer? Yeah, it's Michelle Pfeiffer that's playing, what's her name, right?
Who's
the original Wasp?
Was that Michelle Pfeiffer?
No, she wasn't in there at all. That's what I just said.
Yeah, I know. The but was she in the first movie? Ghost. When he was, when he showed.
No,
they, no, because we no only just saw her as the Wasp.
Right,
we only saw the Wasp.
Because they were like, we don't know if this is going to work out, if people are going to take the Ant-Man, and people took the Ant-Man because it was a fun romp
of a movie. They're going to find her, like, in the
apparently
tiny
I've
universe?
Said too much. But later on, I'll
so throw... now who's talking spoilers, eh?
Later, all right, fine. Hold on. I got spoil. There we go.
Hey, it's right there, all ready to go.
It is right there, and now it's isolated. And, oh, now moving other stuff around. Nah. There we go.
Hey.
All right. So, yeah, they... This is all the spoiler warning stuff for Infinity War now. So, supposedly, they go into the quantum realm to be able to get her out. And Michelle Pfeiffer, I believe, is playing the mom.
Okay. And she's just been in the quantum realm all this time?
Well, yeah, but, see, the thing is in the quantum realm, time works differently.
Of course it does. Which, is she still young?
Well, she's youngish. She's, I think, as old as... She's Hank? Michelle Pfeiffer.
Sorry. I love that answer.
They didn't literally go back in time and get young Michelle Pfeiffer.
Well, no. But I mean, are they, you know, I guess they just, whatever.
She's
okay.
Michelle Pfeiffer.
She's Michelle Pfeiffer.
And so the fact that, well, no. So we'll see time then still runs normal in there then.
That was my question.
See?
So there you go. Like when maybe they pull her out and she ages. I don't know. Who knows?
And turns to dust?
No.
Oh, so when they pull out. Okay. Well, but no matter what, there's supposed to be some kind of importance to their ability to go into quantum realm or something with the technology and their ability to defeat Thanos. A lot of people seem to think that that is time travel specific. But and other people have like they branch off and they figure out a way to do time travel stuff because there's been a lot of hints that it deals with time travel because they've recreated a lot of the sets for the fourth movie, supposedly like specifically the Battle of New York.
They recreated sets for
Infinity War, the fourth movie,
the
for
fourth Avengers,
Avengers 4,
movie. Okay,
they have recreated scenes from the Battle of New York.
First Avengers movie.
Correct. Implying okay. that they go back to that battle to get the Tesseract so Thanos will never be able to get it in its regular... See, that was the time going.
Oh, okay.
That's currently the working theory.
Okay.
The other theory I've heard also is that with the quantum realm being able to shrink down really tiny, that Ant-Man would be able to go into the Soul Gem and get Gamora out. Of the Soul Gem, and that somehow loosens Thanos' power on the Soul Gem because then his sacrifice he made to put in there isn't in there.
Soul Gem.
Thank you for taking your mouth away.
Can't not do that.
I appreciate that.
You're welcome.
All right, so that's it for spoilers then?
And I think so. Yeah, right, no more discussions.
Yeah, you don't know anything, so.
It's just insult after insult. Well, so their big bad guy is Ghost.
Yes, their big bad guy is Ghost.
Okay. Was she always a woman in the comics?
I have absolutely no idea who Ghost is. This is my first experience with Ghost.
Ooh.
And, oh, well, it looks like I have to throw a spoiler warning up there again. Because I don't think it's been covered in any of the trailers. The Michelle Pfeiffer stuff was.
Uh-huh.
If it's Michelle Pfeiffer. Now I'm going to feel bad. If it's wrong, every time I'm going to flash up on the bottom, whoever it is.
Yeah, not much. I'm pretty sure. I like the tone of these movies. I love that each character's movie has its own tone. So that, you know, it's... You know, the Thors are always a little more... Although the last one wasn't. The last one was definitely... Ha!
Yeah, they definitely changed that one up.
But the Ant-Man's, and the humor is different depending on, I mean, of course, it's reflective of the writers are different and the directors are different.
I guess we can take down a spoiler flash.
The humor is slightly different, and I, like I was saying earlier, I love Paul Rudd's.
Mm-hmm.
I love his reading of, like, the enthusiasm of just, like, of Ant-Man's, like, oh my God, look at this,
well, yeah,
look what
because...
I can do, now I'm 65 feet tall, oh my God.
Yeah, because he was never in it to be a
no,
superhero.
He was just a, yeah.
I'm looking forward to this movie just on its own, not even anything dealing with any of its tie-ins to Infinity War, which it shouldn't have a ton until it gets near the end.
Yeah, probably. I would think like a cutscene or...
I'm assuming that Hawkeye swings by and picks him up to head out and do some ass. I'm wondering if this whole story wraps up before the snap and we won't see the snap at all.
He made it through the snap, right?
Who he?
Ant-Man did.
Yeah, because they're going to be in the movie in the next one.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying. Like, so the cutscene may be...
Yeah.
Like, maybe it's like after the snap and he's like, it could I got to go see if Hank and Hope are okay.
Of course Hope's going to be all right. She's got to be in it too. They got to throw everyone at that. They're going to stuff Hank into an old outfit. That'd be funny.
Stuff Hank and Michelle Pfeiffer.
So that's another Trailer Thursday, not Trailer Tuesday, because even though it sounds good, we got to leave that open.
Thriller Thursday.
All right, so I'm Corpulent Geek. That is
Sci-Fi Christina.
And that's it for us today. Thank you, and we'll see you next week. Remember, if you like something about these trailers today, comment down below. And please subscribe and hit the little bell so you get notified. Is it this way?
No, I think it's...
That way?
This way.
All right, that way. All right, over there, hit the bell. Someday I'll learn. Probably never. It's my thing now, not knowing.
So, hit the bell somewhere over down.
Yeah, somewhere. Just click. Constantly just hit refresh on my page. How about that? And watch things while you're waiting.
Stick around.
All right. We're going to cut all that part out and probably just say thanks for watching.